morning, dear students. Today we are discussing about human digestive system. Human digestive system includes buccal cavity, another name is a mouth, then esophagus, another name is a food pipe, and stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, anus. These are the main parts of a human digestive system. Human digestive system includes a buccal cavity, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum, anus. Clear? So you already know that we are intaking food during the morning session, afternoon session, and night time, isn't it? On that time, when you are chewing the food with the help of the teeth, you just feel that there may be some water molecules are coming to the mouth, isn't it? That should be termed as a saliva. Okay, so here in the mouth there may be salivary gland is to be present. This salivary gland secreting some enzyme, that is a saliva. Okay, so this salivary gland secreting saliva. So when it mixes with the food items, it may be little bit digested. It may be little bit digested, and after that, it may reaches into the esophagus. It may not be coming very fastly, but the thing is that slowly the food particles are to be entering into the esophagus. That movement is to be termed as a peristalsis. That movement of food particle is to be termed as a peristalsis. Okay, then after that it may reaches into the stomach part. After that it may reaches into the stomach part. Okay, these food particles are to be reaches into the stomach part. In the stomach, it is a U-tube like structure. You can see the structure of the stomach. Okay, so here some gastric glands are be there. These gastric glands secreting hydrochloric acid, mucus, and pepsin. So here hydrochloric acid is to be acting as an acidic medium. This hydrochloric acid is acting as an acidic medium. And here I already mentioned that mucus is protecting the inner lining of the stomach. And next is the pepsin. Pepsin help the protein synthesis. Okay, so here that is the thing present in the stomach. Okay, after partial digestion, that should be taking in the stomach, and then the stomach transferring these food particle into the small intestine. Okay, this is a coil like structure. You can see inside there may be lot of coils. You can see, okay, almost 7.5 meters long, these are coils. Okay, so here is the complete digestion takes place. Okay, in the small intestine there is a complete digestion takes place. So here you already know about pancreas, liver. This liver secreting bile juice. Okay, the liver secreting bile juice. This bile juice should be stored in the gallbladder. Okay, so this is the liver secreting this bile juice into the small intestine. And in the small intestine, fat means we are taking lot of fat content food items, isn't it? So for example, you are taking chickens, you are taking muttons, egg, etc. So this should be digested in the small intestine with the help of these bile juice. Clear? And complete digestion of carbohydrate, protein, and fat molecules should be digested into the small intestine. Okay. So, and after that, waste materials are to be coming to the large intestine. These are waste materials are to be stored in the large intestine. In the small intestine is the place where the complete digestion of protein, fats and carbohydrates should be taking place. Okay. So then there may be some villi like projections are be there. Means we can when you go through the microscope you can see some projections, finger like projections in the small intestine, that is the villi. Okay, that is the villi. So what is the function of villi is that small intestine is the place where the complete digestion occurs. On that time the nutrients, whatever things a body required, that nutrients should be directly transferred into the bloodstream with the help of these villi. Clear? So nutrients is very essential for the growth and development of animals. So directly these nutrients are to be transferred into the large, to the bloodstream. Okay, so that is the thing. And after that, waste materials are coming to the large intestine, and it may be stored into the rectum, and through anus it may be removing. Okay, all the waste should be coming from the anus. Okay, so this is the digestion process. I think all of you understood about the digestion. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.